Hello, anyone and everyone. I am Echo, and today we're exploring Obduction. So in the last episode, we came over here, and we found some clues, maybe, sort of. We read the journal, it led us to this, which says North Carolina on it. We found the North Carolina license plate, which gave us some numbers, but those numbers seemed to be incorrect, and we also tried all the numbers from these guys. We tried putting in the dates that they served. We tried putting in the date that Luther Roscoe died, except we couldn't actually find his, we couldn't really read his grave very correctly. We've tried so many numbers and so many different things that all seem to make logical sense that nothing's working. Nothing is opening up that tower with the elevator in it. And now I believe we have, I don't even know where I'm going right now. Oy, 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 oy. Let's get down to the middle of town. Let me take a moment and pause and look at the map that I made real quick. I'm going to kind of just think for a second. We went through the glowbug cave. We went through the section near it. We went through the cemetery. We went on the wall. Actually, there's one section on the cemetery that we didn't go through. So I'm gonna go try that real quick. Oh, but first I wanna go, just on a whim, I'm gonna go and talk to CW. See if he has anything new to say. Cause I don't know, it's kind of unclear when he has new stuff to say. I think the last thing he told us to do was to get the barrier opened up, and we haven't done that. But there have been other times where he's talked to us after we seemingly haven't done much. So, let's see. He's probably just going to call us an idiot. He's wasting his time again. Okay.
There's a cable up next to my big battery out there. If you haven't already, can you plug it in for me? It's one less thing for me. It's not the best time to be explaining this stuff. Now, where the jizz?
Okay. A cable out there by his big battery? Does he mean directly out here? Doesn't seem to be a cable out here. Not a cable. Doesn't seem to be a big battery out here directly outside his house. Does he mean outside of the one in the rail station? Seems odd. I don't remember any big cables or anything. Let me see what else you got to say there, buddy. This time he's probably gonna get mad at me. usually does.
I got the horse sense to get all the trees and roots connected. And my battery. I might as well go boil my shrimp.
Yep. Yeah. He's not impressed. Oh well. Okay. Let's, I seriously cannot imagine what he's talking about as far as the battery is concerned, except for the obvious, the other thing. Oh shit, we can't get over there until we open this. Is this gonna be... Shit. Once I open this, I'm gonna have to go all the way around if I wanna close it again. And we're gonna need to be doing that. Oh, man, this is gonna take a while. It's gonna be some trips back and forth. Oh, and also, if I turn it the other way, I just realized, like, I can't get over there from that direction. Because I can't get on that side right there in order to walk across the platform to get over there. So, even though we've unlocked it, there isn't actually... that doesn't actually help us immediately. I think we'll have to get over there from a completely different direction. We'll probably have to get on that side first, then walk across it like that to get over there. Alright, alright. So, the big battery, I'm assuming he means the generator that we turned on at the very beginning of the game. But I never noticed a big cord that wasn't plugged in on it. That's a pipe, that's not even a cord. This is a cord. But this is already connected, because that leads all the way back to here. Though it is red, so maybe that means it's not actually connected? Yeah, that's the pipe that drew up the gas from the garage. And this has to be connected, this is the only thing connecting the electricity to the other, to the stuff over there. Oh, no, I'm stuck. Please don't get stuck. Let's go to the other side. Anything else around? No. I don't know what battery he's talking about, then. That's annoying. That's really annoying. Oh, boy. The definition of annoying. Okay, well, in that case, let's go back. Let's go back the way we came. And, correct the bridge so that we can walk across it when we need to. What could he mean by the big battery, though? Well, I guess he didn't call it a big battery, he just called it a battery, so let's, down again. Move yourself over here. Is that gonna go all the way past? No, thank God. Alright, good. Let's just keep you even then. Okay. Now, he wants us to plug in his battery. He makes it sound like we just need to walk over, oh, there's the plug, whoops, into the socket, there you go, hey, it's working, but it's clearly going to be more complicated than that, and I have no idea what he's talking about for the battery, except for the generator, that's the only thing I see around here, unless he's talking about something that's down the bottom of the tree, maybe, I'm not sure, alright, anyway, we have one more, place over here to check with the teleportation. I know there's still places that we haven't looked at that we found, like the teleport locations for, but I'm trying to Oy vey. I'm trying to do this with one hand and open my thing to the map with the other hand. But, yeah. So we've done Globug Cave, which led to the scrapyard, the area beside the Globug Cave, which led to the plateau outside the locked door of the scrapyard. We've done the cave right over here that led up onto the plateau as well. We've done... Wait a minute. I think we have already done this, but we did it from the other direction. Because this led... Yeah, this just led to the other side of the plateau, which was... Yeah. Okay. No, so we have been here. We just came at it from the other direction, so I didn't remember it. Okay, and then there's... the section below the wall to the right. The section, like, on the other side of the wall over there, where we went through there, and that took us to the place up on top, beside the wall, and everything. Okay. Alright, so I think we've got everything pretty much covered. Sorry, I just need to, basically keep track of it all to make sure we've actually gone through every section of the teleporter and seen where it all leads. So now we need to go back, we can go back right up into the tower, actually. Back up here. And he straight up told us that we need to get down below the tree. Probably to get to that thing, and various other things that I suspect are down there. And that they're all... you know... going to, we have to connect up the things to the heart. There's that. Alright. Alright, let's go back out this way. And then the, Ooh. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Let me get one more thing correct in my head so I don't forget it. I'll check out this next, I swear to God. But then this up here. We go through here. This takes us out here. And then... this place was the one that leads to the other side of the wall behind Farley's house, and that leads to a section somewhere behind the Bleeder Tower, if that is its name. I can't quite remember, to be honest. So, okay. Alright, let's go back through here. And down to this side over here, which we haven't even looked at yet. It's quite an expansive area as well. But this is the most obvious thing. This is a small sphere of some rocks taken from somewhere with various plants on them and crap. And oh boy, frame rates are dying. Thanks for that, game. Thanks so much. Mushrooms don't seem important. Oh hey, that's a, oh my god, frame rate, please. If my computer's downloading something again, I'm gonna scream. I really wish there was a way to stop that. Yeah, this is one of the ambassador seeds by the look of it. Okay, what's it doing? I don't like this. This is taking us to a completely new area, isn't it? It's gotta be. But we haven't even finished Hunrath. Now the thing's freaking like frozen. Good God, the performance is honestly kind of terrible sometimes. It's basically frozen. Do I have to restart it or something? No? Okay, seems to be working now. Please, game, please stop. Oh boy, oh boy. Oh boy. I'm guessing this is Murray? That's what Farley called the other area that they escaped to, by the way she described it. Okay, well hey, look at that, we found our next age, technically, sort of, our next sphere, I guess would be more apt to call it. Oh man, and this one's a big friggin' jungle with super futuristic space technology in it. Oh, okay, that's cool. That's really super cool. But we need to go back to Hunrath and finish what the hell we were doing. So, yay, let's watch the game freeze itself again. Woo. Woo-hoo-hoo, look at all the pretty lights as we are teleported so far away. And the game just chugs along and freezes as it has to load the entire new area.
Yep.
Fantastic. Wonderful. Any day now, game. Be careful you don't move too much, you'll upset the frame rate, I guess. Jeez. Seriously, any day. I mean, this is a pretty loading screen, but I have a feeling this isn't helping it load faster. Thanks. Thanks so much. Alright. Let's go over here now. Ugh. Now that we've seen all that. Oh, don't tell me this is just a dead end with nothing in it. I think it is. Damn it. No. No. Ugh. This just gives us another view of the area down there that we were at earlier. Okay, so this whole section's just for that teleporter, basically. Alright, oh, that's fine, but goddamn. Wish we didn't have to sit through all that just to see the new area. Also kind of worrying, to be honest, that we have access to a completely different area. Because now I'm going to be constantly worried about the possibility of, you know, like what if the solution to a puzzle is across different areas? Then that'd be, oh man, that's going to be horrible for me to remember. I'm terrible with puzzles like that. When you have to travel a large distance to find the, oh wait a minute, whoops, went through the wrong one. Down here. Yeah, I'm terrible with puzzles that require you to travel a long distance just to find your, you know, just to like solve it and everything, and just, ugh, it's bad. Okay, so that's where we just were a second ago. That's the teleporter thing. We're on the other side of the rocks. This should take us behind the bleeder, and perhaps at some point another teleportation thing to take us up to that other half of the waterfall. Or not other half. I guess that's not the correct way to word it. Yeah, we can't get up there, of course. But yeah, the other top section. Oh, okay, so it just goes right over the top of the bleeder tower thing. But it does take us to the other side of here. And that is interesting, because here's another teleporter. Okay. And here's the ramp that we couldn't get down earlier. Can we just walk on that, or... Okay, good, yeah. Okay, cool, so this takes us to the scrapyard, so that's, that will help us get over here if we ever need to for any reason. I don't think we would need to. At this point now, I'm having to look around, and I'm having to think... Like, how the hell do we get the code to get into the upper part of the tower? I already tried the stupid license plate thing. And if it is North Carolina, if that is a code to something... Did I read this? Yeah, that was just a list of things that have appeared. If the North Carolina license plate thing is a code to something... And what the hell is it a code to? A 6-digit code. I have no idea. Hey, wait a minute. Oh, first of all, there's a path back here that I don't think I checked. Oh, holy crap. This has another teleporter thing. And I just noticed that one there too. Where does this one lead? Oh, we can't get to that. Never mind. Okay. Well, where's this one lead? I can't believe I didn't check that here. Unless... Is this just... Oh, no, okay, this goes to the cave with the glow bugs. Alright, never mind. Never mind. Whoops-a-daisy. My bad. Yeah, we came from the cave to get over here. That's why I didn't recognize it. But this... That seriously looks like something we should be able to get to. But I guess not. Alright, fine. Thanks a lot, game. Alright, another teleportation thing? Looks like it. Oh, frame rate, please stop dying. Please. Crying out loud. Yep, of course that doesn't do anything. We gotta pull the lever first. Why isn't the lever moving? Oh, okay. I did try pulling it in that direction once, but I guess it didn't want to work. Alright, press the button, see where this takes us. It's gonna teleport us again. Is this gonna just be to a different section of... the jungle place that we checked out last time, which I assume is Marais, but I don't actually know. So I'm gonna call it the jungle place for now. Because the rocks that we were standing on looked like the same type of rocks from that area. Sorry for the yawn. Yeah, they were the same like color and type of rocks and everything like that. So that makes me think these just lead to two different sections of the same other area, perhaps. I don't know, we'll see. We'll see when we get there. Oh, this place loaded a lot quicker. Oh shit, this looks cool too. This looks so cool. Oh, and there's all this stuff floating in the air. Oh my god! It's freezing up. Please, game, stop. Please. Oh my god. Crying out loud. Seriously, why is it, like, just frozen now? God, I'm gonna have to just destroy the settings of this game to get it to work, aren't I? Okay. There, it's working now. So this... Okay, that's a jungle over there. That is the end of another dome. with a jungle on the side of it. And this looks like it's... This seriously looks like an area straight out of Riven. And there's another red laser hitting the thing to deactivate the teleportation of the dome. And over on this side... Oh, we can't... Can't seem to walk over there. There's a like a elevator or something, though. Yeah. So is this just like right beside the jungle place that we saw with the other teleporter? Like the other teleportation thing that we used that took us to like a jungle place? Is that right over there? And this is right beside it physically? That's kind of weird. And what is that thing on the rock? Oh, it's a little glow bug. Little dudes that show us around and try to help us out. Oh my god, this area looks amazing. Oh my god. This is the best. And we have to go back. We have to go back to Hunrath. I'm never gonna friggin' complete any puzzles if I spend all my time going around. Freaking just looking at all the pre-sites of all the different areas, like, oh my god. Need to make progress. Need to complete some puzzles. Need to find where the frick that code goes. Because this is driving me crazy. We talked to CW, and he said that we need to get below the tree and connect all the roots to the heart. But... He obviously didn't give any clue on how to do that, and he also said to plug in his battery, which we can't freaking find. So that's fantastic. And how do we get to the other side of the river? Because now we've gone through every teleporter place. Every section of the. The dome that lets us teleport, except for the one that's on top of the waterfall that leads to the backside of the bleeder tower. That's the only one that we haven't been able to access because we can't get up to the top of the tower again. Or top of the waterfall, I mean. But, yeah, the other side of the river... There's no way to be on the left bank of the river. Like, there's no way to be on that side of the river and to turn the wheel so that we could walk across the bridge to get to it. At least not that I know of. Also, I just noticed... Now, from looking at it farther away, the whole rail yard section is also its own sphere dome that was cut out of wherever it came from. And obviously, the garage is too. I already noticed the garage, though I don't think I commented on it. But I never noticed the rail yard one. That's cool. The whole area is basically just cobbled together from different spheres taken from different time periods and everything. Even Hunrath. Like, Hunrath is the most basic of the three areas that we've seen. Like, one's a big jungle with fancy alien technology all over the place. One's a crazy, mountain cliffside thing with that looks like it's, like, literally straight out of Riven. And Hunrath is, like, a human town surrounded by red rocks. But even Hunrath is, like, breathtakingly beautiful, honestly. It looks amazing. Because the art design of this game is so goddamn good. So, obviously, I think we still need to just find a way into that stupid tower. But I'm also really wondering about this, because if we turn the thing to the left, and... Well, with the direction it's in now, we can't get across there. If we turn the thing to the left and make it so it's connecting these two, then we can't get over there to even use the bridge to walk across. And I don't think our character can run fast enough to, like, pull the lever and then run over here and get on the thing before it turns, because the thing, like, turns pretty much immediately. And yeah, man, this is... confusing. That's what it is. It is certainly confusing. Alright. Let's... Man. Let me try punching in the... Well, maybe... No, punching in the code again is not going to work unless we can somehow... I don't suppose we can figure out some way to interact with this other than just using the... No, that's not going to work. Other than just turning the numbers, because we can't put in the NT or anything like that. Huh. Alright, well, let's go back across. Just before I end this, I'm going to go back to, I think, the mayor's office. Well, actually, no. We can take a look in the mayor's office real quick, I guess. Yeah, we'll pass through the mayor's office as we go towards the workshop. Because maybe that's what CW was talking about with his, saying to plug in the battery. Maybe there's a battery in the workshop that we could plug in that we didn't notice before? Nothing else in the garage that needed to be plugged in. I think. Maybe. Shit. Alright, well, real quick, let's, press the buttons. Press all the buttons, just in case. Nope, still not working. Okay. That's fine. That's great. I don't mind, game. Really, I don't. Let's go back down here. One more time, real quick, and let's check in the around the area surrounding the garage. See if there's a battery in there that he might be talking about when he's saying to plug in his battery. I swear, the generator is the only thing I could think of that makes sense for that. The only thing I can remember, at least. Oh my god, please frame rate. I swear to god, I'm just gonna dump the game's stuff into the ground if it's gonna keep doing this. It was fine the last few episodes. And since we, since I lowered the draw distance, the frame rate was pretty much alright. But for some reason, this whole episode, even excluding the parts where it had to load in new areas and pretty much froze for a few seconds while it loaded, even excluding those parts, the frame rate's just gone all the way back to horrible garbo levels. And it's not fun. Not fun at all. See anything else there? That's not a battery. That's a big alien sphere thing. Ugh. Is there a battery in here he wants to connect? I highly doubt it. I highly suspicious of that music, too. Seriously, the music always, like, picks up when you're, like, close to finding a clue of something. But just then, it basically picked up for no reason at all. Is there a battery in here? Nope. Battery in there? No, there's not gonna be a battery in there. Alright, now let's just look at the workshop real quick. Maybe he means the thing up there. Actually, that might make sense. Maybe he's talking about that thing that we already, like, turned the lever for at one point. Oy vey. Let's take a look around. Nothing on that side. Those aren't anything. Maybe he's talking about this thing. Maybe this is what he's talking about. Which we already did. Battery capacitor log. Blah, 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 new plug, work begins on battery, power test, blah, blah, blah. So this is the battery then. And we plugged it in. We already plugged it in. Because we pulled that lever thing and we put it all into place. There's nothing else we can interact with. Okay, so it's plugged in. And when he says, when we, like... Yeah, when we tried talking to him the second time, and he gave us the line, if you don't have the horse sense to... That's not a button, is it? No, it's just a light. Better be a freaking light and nothing else. Yeah, he said the line, if you don't have the horse sense to get the heart connected and to plug in the battery, then I might as well go boil my shirt. That doesn't mean that we haven't done either of those things. That just means we haven't done both of them. And after we do both, then he'll change what he's saying. But for now, I'm 99.9% sure that is the battery. And because we've pulled the thing closed, we've plugged it in. And... that thing. We still don't know what to do with that. Water's still on, right? Yep, water's still on. Just notice this thing, though. This is interesting. It seems like a pass-through. Like, that would be to connect a wire to here, with this end to connect a wire to over here? To this part? That's what it looks like. And maybe that's to power something else. Huh. I'm not sure. Okay, well, anyway, unfortunately, I'm out of time for this episode. I'm way over my time, actually, so I'm gonna have to end it here. I hope you all have enjoyed it, and I hope you will continue to enjoy it when we come back. I'll keep fumbling around in the dark like a blind idiot. Yeah, I'll see y'all next time. Bye-bye.